Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Onyango Olo Jr. Raila Odinga has never been this close to the seat of presidency. I know this week has been his week. Yesterday, Raila Molo Odinga declared self-interest in running for 2022 presidential election. 2022 is going to be Raila's fifth shot on this seat. Raila Odinga ran in 1997. In 2002, he was one of the team that led to the formation of the NARC that has swept almost the whole country and voted for Mwai Kibaki. In 2007, he ran for the presidency against Mwai Kibaki himself, and it is believed and widely known that he won the seat but denied the victory. In 2013, he ran again. Of course, there are some issues that the election was rigged, but we got to the point that we got. Then in 2017, Raila ran again, and he claimed that the election was rigged out, that Uhuru was rigged in, and went to the Supreme Court, and the election was nullified. So 2022 is going to be Raila's fifth shot on this presidency. And I believe this is going to be his last shot on this seat. So, if this is the first time you are bumping to this video, or this is the first time that you are into this channel, please take your few seconds and subscribe to this channel, or you can give a like so that this video might be recommended for some more viewers. I'm going to give you that seconds, few seconds for you to subscribe. One or two. Okay, thank you. Why am I saying that Raila has never been this close to the presidency, the seat of presidency? One, you have handshake. Immediately after 2017 elections, Raila got into an agreement with His Excellency President Uhuru Kenyatta, and they termed the agreement as the handshake. This handshake has helped Raila to gain some mileage within the government. And as you know, Ruto has been somehow an outsider in this government, and the handshake itself has made Raila to commit very few mistakes. Of late, Raila has not been having time to be an opposition leader, so to commit a lot of mistakes so that the opponent can use the mistakes to campaign against him. Two, we have deep state. Initially, Raila has been running against the deep state and the opponents. And this time round, the deep state is with Raila, and this has really helped him to rejuvenate its support base. Immediately after 2017 elections, Raila support bases were really demoralized after that election. And since the deep state is with him this time round, the support bases, I think, have really been rejuvenated as compared to before. Deep state, apart from being the fact that they're deep in the state, they also come with funds, resources, state machineries. Of late, have you watched Raila's functions, the way they're being organized? Very systematic. You can see a lot of investment in them. Where do you think Raila is getting those funds? Can you compare those functions to 2017 functions? They are totally different. That's why I'm telling you that Raila has got an upper hand this time round. So long as the deep state is by his side. Three, you have the Mount Kenya factor. 2022. Mount Kenya is most likely not to produce potential presidential candidate, but they are likely to produce potential deputy president. So, they are likely to support either Raila or Ruto Kalibeja. And on top of that, Raila has really made friends, a lot of friends that were against him in the initial elections, such as the Mount Kenya Foundations. I think this might be a plus for Raila to push for his presidential bid, and this makes him, I think, a little bit more in front compared to William Ruto. Last point is age. Let me ask you this question. How old will be Raila? In any case, he will be the president of this nation by next year. Roughly 77. Right now, he's 76. And if you have a presidential ambitions and you are given two options to support either Raila or Ruto, where are you most likely to realize your ambitions? Who's going to be there for the longest period of time? Definitely, I would go for Raila Amolo Odinga. That's why you're seeing the Oka most likely supporting Raila. They still have got their presidential ambition intact. And it's only Raila that has got a shorter time on the field as compared to Ruto. That's why they're most likely to support Raila as compared to Ruto. So I think, despite the fact that Raila is the most experienced, he's also promising in terms of age, and if in any case he gets the leadership, he's likely to exit the leadership field before Ruto exits it. And that's why I think these guys are going to support him. Otherwise, you have a good day. And I would like to request you guys to subscribe into my YouTube channel for more analysis. Here we do politics, and only politics alone. And we analyze this politics that you're not going to find it anywhere. You're not going to find it anywhere apart from this channel. Otherwise, thank you and bye-bye.